board or a fingernail file. If there's one in the audience, you just have to hand it to me rather than throw it. Then I can play, but right now I've got this snag hanging off the end of my finger.
Yeah, Brad! Woo!
Thank you. that was the beginning of the start. You've been taking the tequila up until the after hour, but don't you take it too hard. It's been 5 long years since you robbed the train to Chico. Now you're in the back of a truck, but that's what's from robbing the last train to Chico. So goodbye and Enrico, good luck.
Frizz Fuller. We can turn this one on. There we go. It's a true story written for a guy named, as you may have guessed already, Enrico. Who would clean up the pizza parlor, which was Frizz Fuller's first and last professional paying venue. Longest career in show business without getting paid of anyone I'm aware of. Find the tempo here. Thank you. I can't get away any night without doing this next tune. Too happy. Almost. I was was out one night in Nashville with Ricky Lee Jones trying to find the beach that's mentioned in that tune. It was written for a wedding that evidently took place on a beach. But if you try to think of a beach in Nashville, you run up against a problem. All I can think of in Nashville is Ralph Emery. We found a pond eventually. Sat beside the pond working on a tune that we were doing together, admiring the moonlight as it rippled across the surface of the pond. And after a while, it occurred to me that even though we were seeing the moonlight on the pond, there was no moon in the sky. Upon closer examination, and I did not tell Ricky this, the pond was full of snakes, which look remarkably like moonlight when it's dark enough. This is called Mona Ray. She's a woman who sold furniture in Santa Barbara.
Ooh.
Can you mute me, please? There we go.
Thank you. It means be quiet, too.
This thing's out of grip.
Thank you.
I met Dizzy Gillespie in Italy a few years ago when he was still alive. And we were in Milan, or I was in Milan and so was he. I shouldn't say we were. We were, the location was something that we shared, but that was it. And he was down the street about 9 a.m. loading drums into a station wagon. He was the roadie for the day. And I got the feeling for most days, Dizzy was the roadie. I gotta get a new tuner on this damn thing. And, all we talked about, he came up the street. I waved at him down there and said hello. And he came up the street and talked for about 20 minutes. And all we talked about was sleep. Of all the things you could ask Dizzy Gillespie or say to him, all I could say was, I'm tired. And he said, I understand. Sort of a dark moment there in Italy. Real thrilling conversation. He told me I would have to learn how to take cat naps. I know that this last tune, 8 Miles High, was written by Gene Clark when he was very tired, or he would not have called up the rest of the band and said, I have this great song. I just wrote it. You got to come over and hear this thing. And the rest of the birds showed up. Played it for him, and they said, that is great, but you should call it 8 Miles High, not 6 Miles High. And he lost 75% of the publishing on the biggest hit they ever had. All because he didn't take cat naps. He'd never met Dizzy Gillespie. He'd never adopted the right attitude toward his own maintenance. Or it could be entirely something else. I have no idea. When I was a trombone player, I had a faint idea of Dizzy Gillespie. I was more aware, if totally incapable of doing anything with it, of the music of Mahler, because Mahler liked trombones, unlike a lot of people. Stravinsky liked trombones. Not that you need to know this. Bill Monroe liked trombones a lot. Snoozer Quinn played the trombone. Snoozer Quinn was dying of tuberculosis when a cornet player came in and recorded the only solo record we have of the great Snoozer Quinn. The only connection there is that the cornet and the trombone are both brass instruments. See, I'm a solo act. I don't have to really connect anywhere. I don't have to. But maybe the reason I'm going through all this is by way of this next tune, which is the one that I pretty much learned of. It was written by Pete Seeger. He also had lyrics to this thing, but I can tell you it's really wonderful of me that I won't be singing them tonight. The lyrics really are awful, but it's a great tune. Out of my face, and maybe I'll shut up. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here with you, Yonder Mountain. Thanks for listening.